is basically I will be focusing my talk on massive contracted posterior superior cuff tear, which is a small subdivision in the rotator cuff thing. And by definition, it means that the subscapularis is intact, and you can divide it into large and massive. The large is around 3 to 5 centimeters, and the massive is more than a 5 centimeter tear. And in this particular subset of patients, we need to see the reducibility from posterior to anterior. That is very important. And I'll just focus on to that. So in this subset, the tension-free repair is very important, because if you are going to repair them in tension, you can have anchor pullout or failures because of the high tension. So the goal should be to do a tension under, repair under a low tension. So just this is from Dr. Burkhardt's work. So he has classified massive contracted cuff tears into two types, longitudinal and crescent. And these both are irreparable tears. So if you try to repair them side to side or directly, it is not possible. And for them, he has shown it is actually a very old work. And they have done this work in 2006, 2008 years. And after that, it was just work on that is reduced, but I'll just focus on what they do. So for a massive longitudinal tear, what they do is they used to cut down the coracohumeral ligament area. Basically, they release the rotator interval tissue, and that will usually increase the mobility of the remaining part of the supraspinatus, and then you can do the direct repair. And that was called as an anterior interval slide. For a massive crescent, what they used to do was they used to do both. They used to do anterior and as well as the posterior interval slide, and then repair it direct and side to side. So now for a practical purpose, what we do is basically we rely a lot on margin convergence. So we assess mobility of the cuff edges, and many a times the reducibility is more posterior to anterior, so that you have to keep that in mind. You need to do a generous superior and inferior capsular releases. So that means that you need to remove the adhesions from superior and inferior. You can medialize the footprint up to a centimeter, as enumerated by Dr. Dhananjay also. And then you have three options, which are all controversial. The first is the anterior interval slide that I told you, the release is a tissue which is anterior to the supraspinatus. The posterior interval slide is basically between the supraspinatus and the infraspinatus, and then you can go on with the superior capsular reconstruction. So I'll just be focusing on this interval slide thing. This was first described by Toro and emphasized by Burkhardt. And it is said that if you do an anterior interval slide, you can increase the excursion for about 1 to 2 centimeters. And if you do a posterior interval slide, you can increase the excursion by about 3 to 4 centimeters. So this is a small video. So this is a very large tear, and you can see that the rotator cuff is retracted up to the level of the glenoid. So the first thing here is to do aggressive bursectomy, and you have to identify the spine of the scapula, and you have to mark the level. So this marking is important. I'll show you how I have changed this marking. And then what we do is we use two, usually these tears are laminated tears, like in this aspect. So we use a penetrating suture grasper to puncture both the laminas, and we do it for the supraspinatus separately and the infraspinatus separately. Here we are using a modified Nevesier portal for the supraspinatus passage, and earlier we used a high posterior medial portal for the. And now we see that when we pull it, the cuff is not coming nicely to the humeral head. So if we repair it in this position, the repair will be into a lot of tension, and the repair may fail. So what we are doing here is we are using a scissors to cut it, and this cutting is from the mark that we have made to the level of the scapular spine. And what this does is basically it does just increases the excursion, so the tension on the repair will be minimized. So here we have seen that we have released it up to the level of the scapular spine, and once we are done with that, the excursion part of the cuff increases. So earlier we have seen that the excursion was pretty less, and now this is the supraspinatus part, and you can see that the excursion has improved anteriorly, and this is the infraspinatus part, the excursion is improved a hell lot. So by and large, the goal is to increase the repairability, increase the excursion, and reduce the tension on the repair. Now, this is a very good article by Mochizuki and Sugaya from Japan. And they have basically changed our understanding on the insertional anatomy of the supraspinatus and the infraspinatus. So what they have said is the supraspinatus has got a long tendinous portion and it has got an insertion only on the anterior most part, and the insertion is in the shape of a triangle, and a part of it, supraspinatus, also inserts on the lesser tuberosities. About 21% of patients, the supraspinatus is also inserted into the lesser tuberosity, and majority of the greater tuberosity is a trapezoidal insertion of the infraspinatus. So it has a large insertion. So now what we have done is we have just modified our technique. So our slide is nowadays more curved shaped anteriorly. So we are into the posterior interval slide that we do nowadays is in the line of infraspinatus fibers. So we do a curved release, and so the chances of avascularization or devascularization is actually reduced. Now this is what happens. So there is a superior translation, and once we do a repair after doing a release interval slides, we can achieve a very good acromio-humeral distance. And recently, as I told you initially, the work by Burkhardt was done in 2006, 2008, and after that there were not very much studies on posterior interval slide. This is a fresh study. The interest has again been there in the interval slides technique, and this is a 2018 article from Dr. Nikhil Verma from Rush University Chicago in arthroscopy technique, and here he has wonderfully described the technique of interval slides again, and this is from his article. And what he does is he uses the lateral portal as the viewing portal and do the release by arthroscopic long scissors. So again, he identifies the scapular spine and do a release in the direction. So the rehab is a little bit on the slower side, almost like your normal rehab, but just a little bit more conservative in these patients. And usually they are having a good function. So usually they are elderly patients, but relatively decent function after this repair. Thank you.